Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, we're going to be creating some superhero objects using the super keyword in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You too can become a hero and save our channel by punching the like button, throw a comment down below, and smash the subscribe button. Well, okay, everybody, let's talk about the super keyword. This refers to the superclass, also known as the parent class of an object. That's assuming that you're using inheritance. It's very similar to the this keyword. This refers to the class that this keyword contains, and super is referring to this object's parent class. So here's an example. I have two additional classes, a class called person and a class called hero, like a superhero that extends the person class. So let's set these two classes up. What are some attributes that a person would have? They would probably have a name and an age, so string name and int age. Then let's also create the constructor for this class, but we'll set the parameters up later. And then for heroes, let's assume that all heroes have a superpower. So this will be string power, and let's also create the constructor for this class called hero. Now, when we create a hero object, let's say that we want to pass in some arguments. So let's create our first hero object. Hero, let's call this hero1 equals new hero. And then we'll send some arguments to our constructor for hero. So let's say we want a name, an age, and a power in that order. So our first hero will have a name of Batman. And then an age of maybe 42. And Batman's power is, well, he's rich, so his power is money. All right, now we need to set up the parameters for our hero constructor. So we need a string, an integer, and a string again. String name, int age, and string power. And we are going to assign these values to each of the attributes that our heroes have. So this.name equals name, this dot age equals age, and this dot power equals power. Now, the way that I have written this does work, but it's actually not the best way to do this. Since we declared our name and age variables within the person class, we should really assign these values within the constructor for the person class. And with our hero class, we only declared a power variable, so we should assign the power value within the constructor of this specific class. So what we would like to do is send our name value and age value to the super class, to the constructor of the super class. And if you want to get the attention of the super class, you have to use the super keyword. And the super keyword works very similar to the this keyword. This refers to this class that we're in. Super refers to the super class, also known as the parent class, which in this case is person. So we would like to call the constructor of the superclass person. So we have super set up, that's referring to our person class, and now we need to call the constructor. So all we do after super is add a set of parentheses, and that is it. And we would like to pass in the name and age value as arguments. So let's do that. Name and age. And we no longer need these two lines. We can simply put these within the constructor of our superclass, person. And our person constructor will take care of that for us. But we also have to set up the parameters for name and age. String name and int age. And that's it. So you can see that that error went away. So when we create a hero object, we're going to pass in a name, an age, and a power. And when we construct a hero object, we have our parameter set up, a name, an age, and a power, because all heroes should have a name, an age, and a power. So we're immediately going to send our name and age values to the constructor of the superclass, which is person. And the person constructor will take care of that for us, because that's its job to assign names and age values to those variables. So then we can actually print out all of these values. System.out.println hero1.name, and let's do the same thing for age and power. hero1.age and hero1.power. And this should display everything. Batman, he's 42, and his power is money. So let's create another hero for another example. So this will be hero 2. And this will be Superman. I don't know how old Superman is, but let's say he's 43. And his power, well, he can do a lot of things, so let's just say his power is everything. And let's get rid of these print line statements because we won't need them anymore. Alright, so one thing we can do too is use the super keyword to call a method within the super class. So let's say our person class has a toString method to display the name and the age variables. So let's create that. So we need to add the public keyword to this. There's a separate video on that. Public, we're returning a string, and this is the toString method. And all we're going to do is return our name and our age. So return this dot name. I'll add a new line just to format this. Plus this dot age. And a new line. And we should be good. So here's where the super keyword comes in. Let's say we have a toString method within our hero class as well. And I'm just going to copy this and make a few changes. So we also have a toString method within our hero class. So what we could do is first return the name and the age. So we would like to call the toString method of our super class. So we're going to use the super keyword dot and use the toString method. But we would also like to add the power that we have. So we're just going to tack on plus this dot power. And that's it. And let's display hero 2's attributes. So system.out.println hero 2.2 string. And this should display all of the attributes that our hero has. Superman, he's 43 years old, and his power is basically, well, everything. So that's the basics of the super keyword. It's really referring to the super class of an object, whereas this refers to this class. Well, that's the basics of the super keyword. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the super keyword in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.